Good morning, friends. Myself, Professor Prashant Mahajan, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. So, in the last two lectures, we have started unit number 3, that is engineering materials, and in that, we have seen first is engineering thermoplastic, and the example which we have seen is polycarbonate. And in the second lecture, we have seen biodegradable polymers. And example is Biopol, that is polyhydroxybutyrate valerate. So today we will see conducting polymers. So what is conducting polymers? So conducting polymers are the polymers which are the conductor of electricity. But generally what we know, that is generally polymers are bad conductor of electricity. But there are few polymers which are conductor of electricity. That means there are three types. That is, first is intrinsically conducting polymer. That means that polymers which conduct electricity on its own. That means it is having structural arrangement such that it can conduct electricity directly. So what are the structural requirement to carry the electricity or conduct current? That is, first, polymer chain has system of, first, it should be linear and planar. Second, it should have conjugated double bonds which conduct electricity due to mobile electrons. Then third, highly crystalline and planar. Then presence of aromatic ring in the chain with continuous resonance increases the conductivity. So that is the basic structural requirement to be the for the polymer to be acting as a conducting polymer. So this you know very well, that if the conductivity of material is less than 10 raised to minus 8 Siemens per centimeter, then it will be acting as insulator. If the conductivity is in between 10 raised to 2 to 10 raised to minus 8, then it will be acting as semiconductor. And if the conductivity is greater than 10 raised to 2 Siemens per centimeter, then it will be acting as a conductor. So we will see some examples of intrinsically conducting polymer. So these are the example. First is transpolyacetylene, then polyparaphenylene, and then polyaniline. So you can see this is trans, that means the attachment to the double bond are on the opposite side. So hydrogen, you can see it. So that is the transpolyacetylene. So you can see the structure is planar, the structure is crystalline, the structure is having alternate single bond double bond, that is conjugation. That's why it is conducting the electricity. Then that is, second is polyparaphenylene. So that is the phenyl ring is attached to the para position. So you can see this is a one position, ortho, meta and para. So that is, you can see single, double, single, double, single, double. Then this is polypyrrole, this is polyaniline. So these are the some examples of conducting polymers. Okay, next is extrinsically conducting polymer. So in that there are two types. One is conducting element filled polymer. So means we are going to add some conducting elements, that is we are going to blend it with the polymer. So we are going to blend with either metal powder, metal filament or graphite. So it becomes a conducting material, but it is not by the plastic but due to the polymer. And second is blended conducting polymers. That means we are going to add conducting polymer with the conventional polymer, either chemically or physically. So that are the two types of extrinsically conducting polymer. Then next is doped conduct polymer. That means the conductivity of that intrinsically conducting polymers is very less. So we are going to make that intrinsically conducting polymer more conductive by either p-doping or n-doping. So p-doping means what? We are going to create positive charge on the polymer chain by oxidation and by using Lewis acid. And in n-doping, we are going to create negative charge on the polymer chain by reduction and by using Lewis base. So first is p-doping, that is also called as oxidative doping. So Lewis acid like I2Br2, ApCl3, PF6, AsF5 can be used as a p-dopant, and that will create, as you can see, this is the polyacetylene plus I2, it is going to carry oxidation and it will give you positive charge on the polyacetylene molecule and negative charge on the I3. So that is given positive charge on the polymer chain, and it will give you polaron. So what is polaron? Polaron means radical cation. So you can see in the reaction, that is, this is the trans polyacetylene and it is going to react with this I2. As you can see that polyacetylene is reacted with iodine in CCl4. So you can see there is a first step, partial oxidation. That means there is a generation of two radicals, that is 1 and 2. Then in the second, there is a generation of one radical and one positive charge on the polyacetylene chain. So if one radical and one positive charge is present, that is called as polaron. Then second, when second oxidation takes place, there is a generation of two radicals and two positive charge, that is called as bipolaron. And that radical is going to move and that will form soliton, and there is a generation of two positive charge on the polymer chain. So as we know, the positive charge and negative charge move faster as compared to the double bonded electrons. So this is the p-doping mechanism. So p-doping means positive charge on the polymer chain. Then next is n-doping, that is reductive doping. That means the negative charge is present on the polymer chain and it can be created by Lewis base, and Lewis base like sodium, lithium, potassium donates electron to the polymer chain and it will create negative charge on the polymer chain and positive charge on the Lewis base, that are the metals, that is sodium, lithium and potassium. Then application of conducting polymers. So first is rechargeable batteries. So that is promising charge storage material. So batteries are small size, long lasting, produce high current density. So you can see the wires which are present in the battery, it is having polymer like material, so that is conducting polymer. Second, optical filters, that is radiation from computer screen can be absorbed by the conducting polymer. So third one, sensors. So as we see in the last unit, that is electroanalytical technique, that is the polymers can be used as a sensor for the measurement of the concentration of the particular ion. So in this case we are going to use glucose triiodide oxidized polyacetylene, which is used as a sensor to measure glucose concentration. Then next, in electronics, that is LED data storage, light emitting wallpapers. So that is the electronics application. Then photovoltaic cell and telecommunication system. So that are the applications of conducting polymer. So this is the polyacetylene which we are discussing about. So it is prepared from the acetylene. So acetylene is carbon-carbon triple bond, and it is going to react with Ziegler-Natta catalyst. So what is Ziegler-Natta catalyst? It is TiCl4 plus AlEt thrice, that is triethyl aluminium plus titanium tetrachloride. That is called as Ziegler-Natta catalyst. And at minus 78 degrees Celsius, it is going to give cis polyacetylene, which is having conductivity 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 9 Siemens per centimeter. That is That means it is like insulator. Okay, 10 raised to minus 9 means insulator. When we heat that cis polyacetylene to 200 degrees Celsius, it is going to convert into trans polyacetylene. That means its conductivity is going to increase from 10 raised to minus 9 to 10 raised to minus 5 Siemens per centimeter. So this is still like semiconductor. So this is insulator, this is semiconductor. And when we are going to dope, so what is doping? Doping means we are going to create positive charge or negative charge on the polymer chain, that is called as doping. So you can see the conductivity increases like metal, that is 400 Siemens per centimeter. So this is the thing which I am discussing. So its conductivity is 400 Siemens per centimeter. So this is having conductivity 4.4 into 10 raised to minus 5 Siemens per centimeter, and that will have conductivity like 400 Siemens per centimeter. So we are going to improve conductivity of intrinsically conducting polymer by doping. And application of polyacetylene is used in electrical wiring or electrode material. And third is which we already discussed, that is triiodide oxidized polyacetylene used as a sensor to measure glucose concentration. So which we have already discussed. And these are the three scientists which has discovered the polymer polyacetylene that can be conductive like metal. So these are the three who discovered polyacetylene as a conducting polymer. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you very much.